Developing right now, 18 former Penn State frat brothers are back in court today, charged in connection to the death of a sophomore pledge, and a judge will soon decide if there's enough evidence to go to trial. Fox 29's Dave Kinchin was at that hearing and joins us live from Bellefonte, Centre County. Dave.
Ian, that hearing literally just ended minutes ago, and defense attorneys started hammering away at testimony from the lead investigator.
Looking forward to asking some questions today.
The young defendants and their attorneys made their way into day two of a preliminary hearing where 18 ex-Beta Theta Pi brothers face a slew of charges for the hazing death of 19-year-old pledge Timothy Piazza. His parents enduring a continuation of Centre County DA Stacey Parks Miller recapping and expanding on text messages showing fraternity members fearing getting busted for running a boozing marathon known as the Gauntlet that would have deadly consequences.
The Piazzas have sat there as patiently as any grieving parents could possibly do.
State College Police Detective David Chicatano was back on the stand testifying that the text messages showed fraternity leaders were afraid of going to jail and being sued for Piazza's death, but still efforted what prosecutors call a cover-up. Make sure the pledges clean the basement and get rid of the evidence of alcohol. Fraternity President Brendan Young of Malvern texted the frat's pledge master, according to court records. And in a text message from Young to his girlfriend, quote, "At the end of the day, I'm accountable for it all." Computer records showed one of the brothers searching online to see how 9 drinks in an hour affect a 200-pound guy. And attorney William Brennan hit back at accusations that his client, 20-year-old Joseph Ems of Philadelphia, was involved in planning for the booze and that he hit an unresponsive and dying Piazza.
He doesn't swing, he doesn't wind up. You'd have to presume that he made contact, and then you'd have to presume, was his hand open? Was his fist closed? Did he do it to jostle him? And if we're at that level of speculation, the charges should be dismissed against Joe Ames Jr.
The 18 former fraternity members face a mix of involuntary manslaughter, aggravated assault, and reckless endangerment charges after a February night of drinking led to Tim Piazza stumbling and falling several times, including down basement stairs twice and being left for hours with no one calling 911. And defense attorneys are set to continue cross-examination tomorrow. Dawn?
All right. Thank you, Dave.